Alright guys, welcome back to the second day of our very first competition, Season 1. So today on the Radiant side, we have Buddies Gaming vs NyaTim. So both of these teams, right, they won the first game yesterday. So they have to fight each other for the finals that will be happening at around 10:30 later if there's no delay. So joining me today is Soxian again.
Hi.
Yeah, we don't know what to say also.
Hey guys.
10 seconds to go.
Okay, let's talk about the draft.
Radiant's pick.
So the first few bands, standard. Again, that's right, Gyro. This time they banned ES.
Yeah, this, for the past three games, for yesterday, right, ES was like first pick. And finally they decided to ban Urshaker. For Team NyaTim, they were playing with Agnima yesterday. So I don't think they'll be playing it today.
I didn't watch their game actually yesterday.
Yeah, so
but they were the one. But this gaming was the one with the Gyro and AM yesterday.
Yeah, the greedy pick that won Techie and Pudge yesterday.
But actually, they have Storm for this first round. This is also a greedy pick.
Yeah, first pick Storm is quite surprising.
10 seconds to go.
But it doesn't reveal much of the draft yet. Storm is just good.
Yeah, but picking Storm will like attract the other team to pick stuff like anti-mage or something. But then again, I don't think they'll pick anti-mage so early.
Yeah, they'll focus on picking more lockdowns.
Lina has always first few picks nowadays.
Lina is good nowadays because you can go magical or physical with that hero. And even if you support, you can still have Laguna to follow up burst damage, like Lion.
10 seconds to go.
Yeah, basically a physical damage Lion.
Yeah, sort of.
Five
can't suck
seconds.
Mana but can still hit.
Yeah, cool.
Okay, so they pick AM.
Yeah, so the AM really comes up.
But I don't think AM really fully counter Storm Spirit.
Yeah, because I think AM you need to reach very late game for it to really utilize his abilities. While Storm Spirit, once he hits 6, right, he can snowball like mad. And
depends
if
he
manages
to
snowball, if he snowball until out of control, right, they won't be able to drag the game until like what, late 50 minutes game or something.
So they ban Dazzle. Actually, Dazzle is a good pick on their side, but I guess they don't want to face it in case.
I think they might be afraid of the Huska and Shadowgrave combo.
Oh, yeah, that's quite sick.
Yeah, basically, he's at max attack speed or something and he can't die.
Yeah, but I don't think. Seeing yesterday. Not much people pick Dazzle yesterday, only one of the teams picked Dazzle. But they forgot that there was Dazzle in their hero pool.
Yeah, and the team that picked Dazzle really.
Yeah, they won the game because they were wasting a lot of spells on the Grave unit.
Yeah. So, as usual, the task is gone. Disruptor gone as well since they. They are trying to protect the Storm Spirit.
Yeah, I think Disruptor sort of counters Storm Spirit.
Like,
have you seen the solo mid Disruptor before?
No, with B does.
No, it goes for Agar Street. It destroys Storm Spirit if he gets the ulti off. Because it disables the item usage. Yeah.
That's quite sick actually, but I don't think they will want to play a disruptor mid as well.
Unless you can pull it off.
It's a very weird combo. But I have to say that the disruptor thunderstrike is quite painful actually if you max it first.
But you can't really gank if you max thunderstrike.
Yeah,
usually you will go for the glimpse. Max glimpse. Then you can bring Storm back easily, waste all his mana.
let's see if we can see a few good glimpses today, because quite a number of glimpses yesterday wasn't that successful. Most of the time, the glimpses, they landed up back at the same spot.
Yeah. Not for this game now.
Yeah, because team, NyaTim was, they chose Disruptor yesterday, and the Disruptor didn't really do much, because yeah, most of the glimpses they did right wasn't very successful. They just stay at the original spot. Oh, they are taking very long for this third pick. I wonder what happened.
Maybe they're thinking of what to pick to counter Storm. I think Bane would be good. Bane or someone that has a very long period of stun. Even Death Prophet is good against Storm.
Death Prophet. Stun
is so long.
Dire's pen.
Yeah, I think Omni is. Omni and Huska is crazy.
Yeah, it's similar to Desert Shadowgrave actually.
Yeah, but you have a more early advantage for Omni and Huska. Like, you can just keep going very aggressive. Like, Huska is a range help. You can just destroy the lane.
Yeah, you can spam, but you can choose to add more skill points to Burning Spear as well, since Omni Knight can just heal you back to
5 seconds.
But yeah, I think Bristleback against Huska would be
time.
Not the best pick.
Radiance pick.
Like, you have to face your back whenever Huska throws the spear, so you can't really farm.
Yeah, that's true. And yeah, because they picked the Omni Knight quite fast.
Yeah, I guess that's the combo which they wanted. They were hoping that they don't ban Omni Knight, and they only ban Dazzle, so Omni Knight was a good pick from their side.
Yeah, and they take very long to choose the Bristleback. They have only like 11 seconds left of their reserve time. So if they pick one fast one again, right, NyaTim won't have time to think about what they want to ban or pick next.
Yeah.
Reserve time.
I guess they really are thinking about how to lock down Storm. Like, they have a... they have Omni Knight and Storm now, so it's like, if Omni Knight rotates to mid and help Storm, right, then you can very easily get counter gank. Like, Storm can easily just run away from most of the ganks with Omni Knight.
Yeah, if he choose if he focus on a lot of skill point on repel, right, basically Storm is like always 10 second BKB.
He doesn't even need to max repel, he can just leave it at level 1.
Yeah.
And he can help him get away from most of the engage.
Yeah, 6 second repel is more than enough for the
start. And the Storm doesn't need a BKB with Omni Knight, so he can just go crazy. So it's like, I think maybe Dire need something that can, someone that can buy Diffuser. But looking at their lineup, it's like quite difficult for them to pick.
Yeah, there's no one that can take Diffuser actually.
Yeah.
Lina, I don't think Lina will get it.
I think maybe Bristleback can get, but I'm not sure.
But if you get a Diffuser play on Bristleback, it's quite weird.
It's okay, you can chase, but it's just that you don't synergize with any of his skill.
But it can slow like mad.
Yeah.
Oh, Witch Doctor.
Yeah, so actually they're quite a physical team, Radiant. Other than Omni Knight and Storm, the rest of their heroes.
Actually, Omni Knight goes quite well with Witch Doctor, so they can just repel and Death Ward. They can't do anything.
Yeah, but like that, it gives a problem to Omni Knight. Like, you don't know who to repel sometimes.
Yeah, so actually all of the target, any of them can get a repel.
Yeah, I guess Huska don't really need a repel since
Radiance.
Like, I can just jump in.
Yeah, and his magic resistance is so high, so he wants spells to be on him.
But yeah, when I was playing with Huska the other day with Lina, once his HP, when he goes below half at Laguna, he like takes no damage at all.
Yeah, when you play Lina against Huska, you generally want to Laguna straight when the Huska is full HP, so they don't waste any of the damage. Then after that, you focus down with the Fury Soul. If the Lina is quite ahead, not a support Lina. But I think this case,
5 seconds.
It should be the Lina mid.
Unless their last pick.
Reserve time.
Naga Siren.
Naga Siren. But Naga Siren don't really go well with their hero.
But Naga is good because heroes like Huskar and Storm will tend to die very far. So Naga can actually help reset the engage for their team, like to position themselves in a good place, if played correctly.
Yeah, actually, like once Omni GA or Witch Doctor Death Ward, the Naga can just activate his ulti just to cancel everything.
Yeah, and if Omni try to repair anyone, you just isolate the guy. So yeah, I think Naga is quite a good pick, but just that Nia team doesn't look like they have a very good lockdown, other than Nina in line.
But Naga Knight can go over repel right on Omni.
Yeah, I can.
Yeah, but that might be one of the reasons why they picked Naga then.
Yeah. Okay, so but even if you have a net over Storm, Storm can still jump.
Oh, yeah.
So it doesn't really help.
So their last pick was Clockwork. So we have seen a lot of Clockwork yesterday as well.
Actually, I think every game I saw there was one Clockwork.
Yeah, I think so as
I think Clockwork is quite a good hero. In general, people like to play Clockwork also.
I'd get ready if I were you.
Okay, so let's take a look at the different... Eh, shit, what happened to my... There's something wrong with my...
What happened?
I can't click on the map.
What's wrong?
I know, I can't jump to the map.
You can't jump to the map?
Yeah, I can't right click on the mini map and it flies over there.
Is it you got something over your screen?
Shit, I can't restart the game later. I'm the creator. Oh, I have no idea what happens. I can I guess I'll just cast like that. Oh, it'll be damn difficult actually.
Click on the heroes, I think you should click on the heroes. Just
oh yeah.
Click on the heroes and follow them.
Yeah, that's my only solution now.
Can you pan your camera?
I can pan my camera using the center click and like push to the side. Oh. Okay, at the bottom lane, anti-mage is going to find Huskar. I don't think he wants to go there. He's the only one there. Okay, yeah, at least he has a blink.
He's still not. He hasn't up his skill yet, so he's thinking of what to up. It will be
30 seconds to battle.
Will AM be offlane? Oh no, they're just trying to get the bottom lane. So I think this gives Clockwork the free rune at top.
Oh, actually I can't see anything eh. Suddenly all the hero is missing on my map. Like, huh? I can't see any of the hero. Eh, I can't pause. Can you press pause? Ah?
Well,
you no, I can't
like bloodbaths.
Shit. Okay, never mind.
Money to burn.
Like sometimes.
Wait, what's...
At different position of the map, right? I can't see the hero. They just go invis.
Oh, I think it's a fog.
But I shouldn't be looking at the fog.
I think maybe you press on one of the key.
Oh my god.
Oh,
yeah, I think
fails.
I can't. Oh my god, I can't see properly. Actually. I think I mean it. Yeah, as long as it's not radiant, right? I can't see them.
Okay, I'll try pressing F2 or F3.
It's F1 to see everything.
Yeah, F1 to see everything.
Yeah, I tried already. Oh, this is quite bad. Yeah, I totally can't see, like, as long as they are out of the fog of radiant, I can't see them. Okay, this sucks. Okay,
I want to switch to my screen.
Yeah. How do I switch to your screen?
Hang on.
Oh, do I pass you my Twitch key? Then you help me switch over.
No, it's fine. You just host me.
Huh, how do I do that? Can I like switch to what you're looking at?
Dota?
Cannot, right? Yeah, I guess no choice for this game. We will just cast like this for now. I'll double check what's the setting later. So bottom lane Whistler actually it was quite low, but okay, lucky he has south. He finished off his mana. They can burn his mana. He ran out of mana totally. For Whistleback.
Regeneration. Is it? Hang on, I'm trying to help you. Dyer's, I think it's maybe. Yeah, AM. Siege. It's not even on the lane. Not.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not sure. He maybe spam his second skill.
Yeah. He's being pushed. Prismite is being pushed back very back actually. He won't be able to get a lot of experience. And the wards are on top lane and middle lane for Dire's side. So they can't block out the neutral camp for a while. And actually they are not pulling also. So they can't do anything. So Naga Siren is coming over to mid. Yeah, I totally can't ever see Naga Siren. I can only see like one round circle.
Oh dear.
So whoever is watching, I just imagine. There's a Naga Siren and there's a Lina here. If anyone who's in the chat know how do I fix this without restarting Dota, y'all can like just drop me a message there and I'll see if it helps. So I apologize for those who are watching right now because I mean it's actually our first few time doing this, so there might be this kind of error. And Reborn is damn buggy now. So it kind of sucks. So yeah, Bristleback is still level 2. And yeah, not much diff, I guess. But Huskar is farming and very happily.
On your type in your Twitch chat. I'm currently hosting the stream.
Okay. In my Twitch chat.
Yeah, in the Twitch chat. In the Twitch chat. Okay, so the AM got the first dawn. Work.
Sorry for missing that out, but I just hosted it. Can you see it? Oh yeah, I saw it.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Okay, so Xian will be maneuvering the camera for now lah. At least for this game.
Can you see the? Can you use my camera?
I can see it on the stream already, so it should be okay. I hope at least it's recorded properly. I'll be recording the rest also. Reborn sucks, man. Yes.
They're going for
Bristleback. Can they kill it? Hugh lands on Bristleback, but yeah, other than Hugh, there's no more.
Yeah, not enough. Barely. Maybe another spear will be enough.
Yeah, Bristleback is in a bad position right now. He can't farm and he's been driven back all the way back to base now.
Looks like there'll be rotation from.
Yeah, so they are pulling and they can't see anything. So rotation on mid, which Dr. Stun on Lina. And Stormsea is already 6, so Lina should be dead.
Lina is dead.
That
can't
was
do anything
nice.
Against that.
Yeah.
Lina is sort of like SF. Like you can't really do anything when someone gets except for pray for your stun hit on everybody.
Yeah. They say like he doesn't have any runaway mechanism.
Yeah, that's right. It's like sort of like SF.
It'll be quite hard to land an LSA on a Storm, but actually he did that just now.
I mean early game is alright. It's easy to like land without Storm's ball lightning. In late game, I don't think you want to aim a Storm unless you got U Scepter. But even if a U Scepter, wouldn't be able to dodge.
Yeah, it needs to be near instantly. So, let's just hope that Radiant puts more ward so I can see more things.
Oh, you only have vision from Radiant.
Yeah, like I can see the whole map, I can see the arrows here and there, but I can't see
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Where is,
I'll be looking for a gang.
He'll probably be fine.
Yes, he's 6 really.
Are they going to smoke?
His vision is caught up.
We're just helping Lina to farm at this lane. Cloud will scout them out. Yeah, but there's nothing they're
picking them.
Lion, Bristleback. Bristleback, okay, at least he got his boots now, but he can't stop the Huskar now. He's level 4.
I mean, it's the idea of off lane, we just set the experience, but you can't really go near to the lane.
Yeah.
So much harass. And even if you harass the Huskar, there's still the. Omni Knight to back him up.
Yeah. As compared to the Bristol back, right, the Claw is actually doing not that bad. At least he has. He managed to get a chainmail up already.
Yeah, and he's already 6, whereas Bristleback is still struggling for his 5. Is he 6 now? Yeah, he's still struggling for his level 5.
See, just the first blood went to Radiant, that's all.
Yeah, quite a silent game today.
Yeah, okay. Storm Day jumps in, stun on Lina, 2 rotation comes in, I don't think it's fast enough. Oh, they managed to get it.
Oh, he's self off and
net on the doctor. Laguna. Oh, he misses the Laguna. That was a disaster.
They should come from Omni Knight to.
Yeah, and.
It's like there's a counter engage.
Counter.
Yeah, I guess it's dead. Oh, even a hook.
Oh, that was even a hook shot was used.
That's everything.
Yeah, that Laguna evade.
Yeah, that Laguna was. Quite sick.
Not sure if he's. He sway or he's just too. The
yeah, I don't
think
he saw the Laguna coming. He was just trying to avoid. Like,
yeah.
The whole war ground, war zone.
Yeah, but nonetheless, that evasion saved his life.
Yeah. I think that's a very sad Lina right there.
Yeah, if I was Lina, I would be complaining right now. That I think it's 0.5 seconds, right? Because I remember there's a lot of things that can evade Laguna, like fuck face shift.
Yeah.
Radiant's middle tower is being attacked.
I'm not sure, I think that, yeah, there's a small delay.
Oh, invis on Storm's Whip to the bottom, zip in onto the Bristol back. Witch Doctor stun, protect, and ulti.
Yeah. Yeah, Bristol still don't even have his 6 yet, so it's quite a terrible game for him. not the best day for the Bristol back.
Even though he's a Bristol back, but with 3 heroes ganking him and with him as under level, he can't do anything. If
yeah.
You can take a look at his last hit, right, he's like 1-0. He's exactly the same as us.
A support.
Yeah, a support Omni Knight. Will we be able to see another snowballing storm today?
Maybe.
Will they jump in for the Naga? I don't think so, it's too far away.
You can see today's Storm Spirit is trying to go for early Orchid instead of the Bloodstone yesterday. Yeah, I think he just wanna take out Lina. Or maybe to catch attack. AM easily with Orchid.
You don't even care, do
yeah, with early Orchid AM won't be able to get his Manta Storm anytime soon since he should be going for his Battle Fury.
Yeah, I guess the idea. If you wanna go early game, you just go Orchid straight instead of the Bloodstone.
Naga just standing there. What's okay?
Dire's middle tower is under siege.
He support Naga, so he's having a difficult time too. Since he can't do much, even if he get his net off, he can't. There's nobody to follow up the damage. Since it's a Bristle back and the.
Oh, top lane, Storm Spirit. Is he going in? Oh, he saw Lion.
Yeah, he's going
zipping onto the Lion. Oh, half HP gone already.
Oh, he's a stun.
Yeah, he misses a stun. But the rotation was quite fast.
You're gonna
blink
re-engage.
Can, do
doesn't
have
his void. Oh, he has his void.
Yeah, but they don't have the follow-up stun for this. Oh, can they kill? Mana void on Storm. Oh, he's the double damage.
Yeah, he's gonna kill AM if he's
I'm pretty sure he will try to kill. Oh, a stun on Storm. Oh, yeah, Laguna.
No dodging this time.
Yeah, he can't dodge this time.
Dire's top tower is under siege.
It was just a little bit more and the AM would die. The double damage is so painful.
Bristleback still having a hard time at bottom.
Yeah. Oh, his CS is really jialat. Huskar is just free farming now. They can't do it.
Yeah, and his early armlet is like around 10 minutes.
Yeah, and with Omni Knight by his side, right, he won't be going down anytime soon actually.
Yeah.
Even though he don't have his Guardian Angel, right, it's still quite scary.
Okay. Omni Knight actually went for a second level of Repel instead of Aura.
I guess I don't think Aura is useful this for now since they have a lot of people that can jump in. Okay, if
yeah, but it's top quite useful to siege. Actually chase down a Bristle Back since he can only walk away.
Dire's bottom tower is under siege.
Yeah, if Mr. Bat didn't back out just now, he would have died.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire has fortified its structures. Dire's bottom tower.
They're all going to get the bottom tower.
Attacked.
Yeah, it's going to be down.
Dire's bottom tower has been destroyed.
I thought the clock was going to engage on me. Lion is. Lion is free.
They're
going to
go for bottom towers too. Are they going to defend?
Under attack.
Can they do anything? Actually, I can't even see that here.
Dire's bottom tower is
okay,
oh,
so they're gonna catch a storm
can
first.
Can they time me properly? Oh,
oh no,
the hook shot!
Stop.
They stopped the
oh.
They stopped the LSA.
Stun.
Triple stun. Ulti on Lion, they can't do anything. Rage Doctor Death Ward, no one stopping it, and yeah, there's no one in range as well. Oh, an easy kill on Lina. The hook shot actually saves Storm. Yeah, if not, it will be LSA onto Lion's Impale, and yeah, basically they will be able to chain stun Storm Spirit.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Oh, that was a very nice hook shot, even though it's like just in front of his face.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
I thought the range of sleep was like much bigger than that. Like he could hook shot and then go into sleep state.
Yeah, I thought
that's quite near to Naga actually.
Yeah, he was like Naga was here, right? Then the clockwork was just here, I think.
Yeah.
I thought he would have garnered the sleep already.
Dire's middle tower.
Actually,
his
sleep range is quite big.
Yeah,
I'm sure how he did it.
1,200.
Dire's middle tower.
And they managed to place a ward. Oh, I can't even draw the map. What the hell? That sucks. They even place a ward here.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
So
yeah, it looks like this is quite a one-sided game for this is Buddies Gaming, yeah.
Buddies Gaming. And the prisoner isn't doing anything to help out the team also. He's been locked down by the early game as well.
Right. He only has a boots. Doesn't have any items other than boots.
Yeah.
Quite behind. And Naga is really if you play Naga support. Can't really go anywhere. Maybe you help to stack for your teammates. I think Lina and AM is a very good hero to clear stacks easily.
Yeah, but I can't even see you that stack.
Dire's
but I don't think there's any stack now.
Actually, AM sort
Dire's
of cleared
top tower has fallen.
The Radiant stack.
Radiant's bottom tower is
but
being
he doesn't have his military yet, so he can't really clear.
So
that
it will penetrate your wizard's cap.
Yeah,
AM,
keep pushing top.
AM is a bit more away from his better fairy.
Top tower is under attack.
Let's see, still anyone's game. If AM manages to get his better fairy and farm like crazy, he might still stand a chance if he drags very long.
But he's only nearing his better fairy while Storm is already gonna get his orchid. So when he gets his better fairy, he don't have any other items to sort of avoid the silence.
Dire's top tower has been destroyed.
Oh, they just took out two towers at once.
Boom, yeah, they couldn't defend. Stop.
If you realize, Dire, they put up quite an offensive,
so a
defensive
smoke.
One. They should be able to see this.
Radiant's
smoke.
Middle tower is under siege.
Yeah, most likely they saw it.
And the clockwork shoot out a rocket flare, so they know that they are somewhere there, and they are signaling over there.
Yeah, it looks like they're just gonna go get Rosh.
Oh yeah, and yeah, the Dire team also pin out Rosh. So,
but
they
can't really do anything even if they know they are in Rosh. Like, they don't have any heroes that can go in since AM doesn't have his items yet. He's just gonna keep farming.
They are going in, they smoked up, and the Naga illusion will spawn out the promotion. But can they do anything? Glimmer Keep on Witch Doctor.
It looks like they're thinking of going in. Oh, the song's up.
Song is up. LSA, if this lands good, it will hit on 3. Can he do it?
3 man stun.
3 stun?
Oh.
Okay, oh, man should stun only 2-1. Laguna away from. Laguna on the Witch Doctor, and Witch Doctor is down. The stun.
Oh.
Witch Doctor stun has been chaining and chaining. It's bouncing around.
Oh.
Oh.
You're gonna get
oh, the AM
storm.
Can't do anything at all.
Yeah, they can't kill the storm.
Yeah.
Like Lina is just gonna get away.
Yeah, 2-4 exchange. So
that's quite disastrous for Dire. Like, they already pretty much.
And now,
they are like 10k behind. Not sure.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah, they are 10k net worth. They have 10k net worth, and experience actually is just a 2k. So I'm pretty sure that's because of the AM, because he's been farming since just now. Yeah, as for the heroes level, they are quite normal. They are quite equal. Just that the net worth is getting, the gap between the net worth is getting larger and larger. And Visavet has nothing other than his power trends.
Yeah, so you can see actually which doctor has a glimmer cape. So you don't really need the repel from Omni Knight in this game anymore.
Yeah, so you can focus his repel on
yeah.
Oh, Storm Spirit kills.
Yeah, I missed out on that one. Yeah, it looks like he's silenced really.
Yeah, with his Orchid, actually there's nothing AM can do. Yeah. He only has level 1 spell shield, so he can't really block away.
Looks like he can't go for mid. Yeah,
or another.
Just another snowball game for them.
Yeah, and it's the power of the Storm Spirit again. Even though the Huskar isn't getting much kill. Oh, Storm Spirit zip in again. Silent on Lina. The Vortex.
Oh,
he evaded the Impale again.
Evasion.
He has been evading everything. Or jump in on the.
Oh, that finger didn't do anything.
Yeah, because he's already very low.
Yeah, he's really quite low. Together with the Glimmer Cave is. None of those spells can get through him.
Yeah.
The only way I see is he's gonna get Aga.
Dire's middle tower is but she's quite poor.
Dire's middle tower has been destroyed.
There's nothing they can do to stop it.
Dire's middle tower is being attacked.
Yeah, Storm Spirit is too fat. Even though he's only got his Orchid, right? But he's 20 minutes in the game and hookshot.
Dire's middle tower is under siege.
Oh, he has to farm, I guess. Under attack. Oh.
He's gonna get an Aga.
Dire's middle barracks is under
attack. They can't do it. They can't do anything.
Are they trying to engage?
On the Dire side.
A song? Zip in on song? Oh, that's nothing. Just scare him.
Still has the, still has Aegis. So
yeah. Stun?
Are they gonna get the...
Oh, he misses his stun also.
Radiant's top tower is being attacked.
Yeah, it's, they can't do anything. Oh, he jump in onto the lion. Yeah, it, oh, it's very easy kill. And yeah, AM. Oh, AM basically melts down to the death ward. He was forced to blink away just now. That was a very nice death ward there, just to stop AM from coming in any closer. That was a quite easy Rex for Team Buddies Gaming.
I mean that's the most ideal situation, like Huskar and Storm just dive in and WD just helps them protect the background, the back line for the supports to move in.
Yeah, both of them can just jump in, so if they are like around what 800 or 900 range of Huskar, they will just die to Huskar. And when Huskar jumps in right, they will know he won't be the only one jumping in. There will be always Storm Spirit that follows up.
Looks like they know that someone is at bottom.
AM is inside the jungle, the tree, hiding in the tree. Okay, he's TPing back. Okay, he gets his Battle Fury already. Oh, he's very close to. Did the Rocket Fest? No. If he didn't blink out, right, I think Storm Spirit will just zip in.
Yeah, Storm just activated a regen. See if he's gonna dive anyone. Did he see someone? Oh, he saw.
They saw? Is there one?
The
oh, hookshot! Oh, misses. Hookshot misses. But they should be able to see the rest of the team. Oh yeah, they can't track.
Oh, he's gonna zip in with the regen.
He still,
yeah,
has
still
his regen.
Has regen.
Then they realize there's a ward over here. They're pinning out, but do they have anything? Yeah, they don't have anything to take it out. But it doesn't really matter.
But they don't have any sentries or.
Yeah, like even. Oh, Huskar already got his halberd already. He's really farm.
Yeah.
Actually, 5-0. Oh. Zip in onto. Silent on AM. Stun misses again. Hook shot and yeah, AM just meltdown. Oh! The Revenant just melts down Naga, it's a disaster.
Pretty much
the death ward onto Razorback, yeah, this should be game. There's another regen on Storm? Or is the Aegis?
Aegis expired.
So he's back to full mana again. Razorback comes in, I don't think he should be jumping in. Silence on the Razorback, hookshot on the Lina, Cox on Lina, he can't do anything. RSA onto the Clockwork's Blade Mail. Yeah, that should be a dead. Oh, at least he gets a Rage Daughter. And yeah, Razorback just went down. Is it second death?
Second death?
Did he buy back on it? I don't know, I'm not sure.
Oh.
Yeah. I thought he came out. Oh, it's a GG call by Team NyaTim. It's a I think this is one of the fastest games in our competition. So yeah, a 22 minute GG call. Oh, my screen just sink into the ground.
I'm not sure what you're looking at, but...
I'm looking at the crack on the ground, that's all I can see. I can see one crack only. This sucks, eh? Alright guys, we'll come back for our second game later, which is, let me take a look. In TQE we trust versus 70s. So yeah, stay tuned, you'll start round 9. See you later.